genuine pleasure to be here in Australia. It's always had a big place in my heart, this country. It's the country I first came to when I discovered that I was gay. And I'm not, but you guys are fairly adamant.
Daniel Sloss joins us now. Daniel, welcome to the show. A bit of time has passed since that clip, obviously. Is it still happening?
Well, man, I've not been to Australia in 2 years, so you can call me whatever you like as I'm walking down the street now. Send whatever dog's abuse my way and I'll happily take it at this point.
No, I'll promise it'll be nice, Daniel. You've flown here from Scotland and have just finished 2 weeks of quarantine. How was it?
It was all right. I mean, it was, you know, it's 2 weeks in quarantine. It's isolation. It wasn't the funnest experience in the world, but, I mean, I could see out on my balcony every day, like, actual civilization and society taking place. So, you know, it was good. I drank heavily. I got back into smoking, but I'm here and I'm happy.
Is that related to what you just said?
Yeah.
Well, Daniel, Scotland, of course, is still in heavy lockdown. Is it weird being here and seeing people leading, like, relatively normal lives?
Yeah, man, I am like a child at Disney World right now. Like, we've literally gone to a pub today and I'm just, like, looking around, just being like, is this legal? Are people allowed to do this? like, my friend picked me up from quarantine and we got out and we got a taxi and I immediately went to put on my mask and she was just like, we don't do that here. And I was like, oh, my God. Like, it's so exciting. My fiancée is not talking to me. She spoke to me every day during quarantine, but she's just been like, I'll see you when you're home now. Because I don't want to see a single bit of you having fun because it's very unfair.
Well, all of your friends and family are still in lockdown. Are you feeling guilty or gloaty about being out and about?
Very, very guilty. Like I'm genuinely privileged to be one of the few people allowed to come over and get to perform here and just get to experience civilization again. So I posted every day on Instagram during quarantine, and for the sake of all my loved ones back home, I'm not going to post a single thing until I get back. I'll just come back like with an old school slideshow like they did in the 80s, and I'm like, this is me at the beach, this is me feeding a kangaroo, and then this is me eating a kangaroo. 1-1.
In solidarity with your fiance, like when you FaceTime, I'm clear it's obvious that you would. Do you put the mask back on just to make her feel like you're having a worse time than you really are?
She puts one on just so I can't lip-read all the horrible things she's saying.
All right, so I think we can agree that COVID mostly sucks, and especially for comedians in the past year. I know you had to perform in some really odd venues in the UK, including this one, which I just am stunned by.
I tell you what, if my agent offered me this gig in January, she would have been f***ing fired. There is not... My agent in January was like, do you want to drive to London to gig in a car park? I'd rather f***ing die. 15 weeks of no attention and it's a pleasure to be here.
So I think us laughing over that disguised the awkwardness because comedians live for the laugh and suddenly you're just not getting any back. What was that like?
Man, it was weird, but I mean, I hadn't performed in months, so it was exciting to be doing a gig again, but the reactions was just, I mean, it's people honking their horns whenever they're laughing. So when you speed on the way home or you're in a traffic jam, you're just like, I'm crushing this. Like, I must be absolutely... I don't know what I'm doing in this car jam, but I'm absolutely nailing it. People love me.
Mate, your stand-up show called Jigsaw was absolutely brilliant, but it's also been responsible for breaking up more than 120,000 people and claimed 300-plus divorces. Has your fiancée watched that show?
She has. She has, and I think... I mean, she was sceptical when I got down on one knee, but, you know, there it is. Yeah, that's us proposing in the Scottish rain, because if I waited for good weather, I'd have to wait until 5 years from now to propose to
her. Is it going to survive this situation, though, that you've got with you being out of lockdown?
I genuinely don't know, mate. Like, I really, like, it's like this will be the hardest thing we've gone through. Because when we were both at home during lockdown, we were miserable together, whereas now I'm out here having the time of my life.
Yeah. Well, Daniel's got a stack of Australian shows, so head to our website for all the ticket details. You can find them there. Daniel, it's always great to speak to you when you're in town. Welcome
Thanks,
to our shores, and we'll see you again soon.
Hey there, it's about time you finished that video. I contractually had to wait so I could tell you to subscribe. Subscribe. I'm waiting. Now I can go home. Woo!